Hello, friends. It's Lindsey from Okanash Farm. It's been a long time. Turns out that it's really hard to make videos when you're farming full time, pretty much by yourself, and raising three small children. So we haven't done a video in a really long time. But I thought that today, the way that it is, would be a good day to do a video that I've been meaning to do for a really long time. So we have one goose now. We have Greta. We're down to just Greta. And I have been, if you follow us on Instagram or even on YouTube or anything, you know that I'm a huge, huge, huge fan of my guard goose. I will tell anybody that will listen that, oh, you should have a guard goose. If you have chickens, you should totally have a guard goose. Well, there are a lot of things you need to know before you go get that guard goose. And seeing as how spring is right around the corner, and this would probably be the time that you would consider buying that goose, there are some things, some really important things you need to know ahead of time. So I figured I would take this nice snowy day, and I've got my Forster's latte here. And we're gonna just kind of unpack this a little bit and go over some things that you really, really, really need to know before you get a guard goose. Now, when we set out on this mission to get a goose to guard our flock from aerial predators, it was 3 years ago, 2 years ago, three springs ago. Because we've now had Greta for just about almost 3 years. We're going into our third year. And I could not find information about how to raise a guard goose so that it was a guard goose. And I just scoured YouTube and I just found this sort of big hole. So there was, Josh Satin has a good video about Larry, his guard goose, and he's just the nicest guy. I had sent him a message and just asked him a few more questions. And he was very forthcoming with the information, told me everything he knew, but he didn't really have a lot of information on how to raise them to be a guard goose. Justin Rhodes had a real short little snippet of video about, oh, I'm just gonna take this goose and throw it in with these chickens to help protect them. Nothing about how did you get the goose to do that. Alaska Living, I'll put a link in the show notes below with all this information, but they had a video where they were bringing in some juvenile ducklings, I'm sorry, goslings, and they were gonna be raising them with their chickens, but I never saw the follow-up to that. Ooh, I gotta go make English muffins, hold on. Okay, so when we set out on this mission to raise our guard geese, there just wasn't a lot of information. And I'm gonna give you a couple disclaimers here. I am not a scientist. I'm not an animal scientist, I am not a vet. I haven't even been farming for that long. I think I told you I'm in my going into my third year with chickens and geese. I, for a very long time, worked on a children's discovery farm, Davis Farmland in Massachusetts. And I knew that I did not want to have animals on a farm because they are a lot of work. Whatever your reason for getting chickens, whether it's food security, or you just like the idea of it, you think it's very romantic, and you're like, hey, I should probably, you know, I've heard about this guard goose thing, I think I should get a goose to help protect them. You are gonna have to get very comfortable with very uncomfortable things. You're gonna have to come face to face with death and really just awful stuff. It is this very hard part of farming that we tend to sort of romanticize, like, oh, I'm just gonna look out and I'll just have like chickens and geese like wandering around and all these beautiful gardens and shit. It is a lot of heartache. It's a lot of really tough things, doing some really tough things. This year we had to put down Greta's sister Gertrude, which I'll get into a little bit. She had cancerous growths on her face. And I literally had to, we got incredibly lucky. One of our CSA members is a vet tech, and she was willing to come out and look at this growth on her face and We had to bring her into the greenhouse and basically turn it into a little operating room, and it was not what we thought it was going to be. So you're gonna be forced to do some stuff that you're probably gonna be really uncomfortable with, and you need to make that decision with eyes wide open before you just go get some chickens or before you get a goose. And geese have a lot more of that goes with it. That being said, just to, you know, right up front, I still believe in this. My goose is my favorite thing on the farm. I love her so much. I wish I could get some more, and I probably will be getting some more. But we have some big changes coming up here on the farm, which is part of why you haven't seen videos from us. We've kind of been off of social media. We're not ready to talk about them yet because nothing is finalized. Big changes, really exciting stuff, nothing bad. Big changes in the farm, the way we farm, the way we do things. And so we've been really kind of wrapped up in all of that. So we're kind of holding back. We're not going to be doing a CSA this year, because we're going to be pivoting a little bit and doing something a little different. So with that, let's get into this a little bit. Here's my list of the 5 things you need to know before you go get a guard goose. Okay, so just to preface this, I am going to be telling you about our experience on how we successfully raised a guard goose or guard geese from goslings. I am not going to tell you about how to integrate an adult goose or even a baby goose into an already existing flock. That's not a thing that we've done yet. So I'm just going to tell you what we did because we were successful in our mission. And because, again, this isn't information that I was able to find. It was sort of like this hole on YouTube of how to raise a goose so that it will guard your flock. This is something that our geese were incredibly good at. And it completely revolves around the fact that they consider themselves part of this flock of chickens. They're like their babies. Some people will say, well, like roosters can do a lot of the things that geese do. Well, anything a rooster can do, a goose can do 10 times better. We do have some roosters. We keep them around because these ones haven't attacked me. And they do serve a lot of the same purpose, but hands down, a rooster can't really protect your flock from a hawk. A goose can. So the purpose of this is not to protect them from a fox or things like that. It's to protect them specifically from aerial predators. Part of one of the reasons I always said I never wanted to have chickens is because chickens are incredibly stupid. Not their fault. I mean, they have their own social structure, they have their own whatever, but they're really, really bad at keeping themselves safe. Geese are incredibly smart and they're incredibly vigilant. So I am gonna go over the 5 things you really need to know before you get a guard goose. Let's start. Higher protein content. I'll link any of these resources because it's been a long time since I did all this research. I'll link all of that information in the show notes below for some resources for you. We got our geese from Meyer. I can't remember exactly which one. There are 2 hatcheries. It's super confusing. We have French Toulouse, Buff Toulouse. They also make a giant version of it. I have a friend who has a giant gander who is a buff, and it looks like his gander ate like 4 of my geese. That's how big he is. They also are very messy because they play in the water and they dip their heads in the water all the time. So I will see if I can find some pictures or videos from when we had them in the brooder. But it's best if you can, it's much harder to keep that side of the brooder clean. And even the coop, like they're just gonna make a mess with water. We, during the warmer months, right now they're in the coop, but in the warmer months we pasture our chickens and also our geese, which is great because they can make as big a mess as they want. And then we're just gonna move them out of that area in like 5 days. So, you know, they can splash around with the water and they're not gonna make like a mud hole. Otherwise, if you have them in the same area, it's gonna get really wet and muddy. So you really are gonna have a hard time keeping them dry. So we do both, like in our brooders and in our coop, we do the deep litter method. You're gonna have to put a lot more, you're gonna have to put a lot more wood chips in there to keep them nice and dry and safe. I mean, also their poop is also a lot wetter than like a chicken, than chicken poop. So they're just messier. They need that water and they need a high protein content food. Go off of, you know, wherever a good place to start is, wherever you do end up purchasing your geese, ask them questions. A lot of times on their websites, they'll have information. Usually chicken starter feed isn't quite high enough. I was able to find one that had a really high protein content. I want to say it was like 32%. If they don't get the amount of protein that they need, they can develop things like angel wing, which is like one wing just literally doesn't develop. We also, a thing to consider is when we got ours, we had to buy three. We had one that was the runt of the litter. She just never fully developed. I'm actually surprised she made it as long as she did. I think she made it like 12 weeks. And she just was not developing properly and she ended up passing. So, and then we ended up with the two. So
as you can see, they still have a bit of their down.
But they're doing a great job eating grass and all that. But they have outgrown the brooder. They are just too tall and it's just too crowded in there. So number two, geese grow very quickly. Our geese outgrew our brooder way before our chickens did. Especially we had the deep litter method, and even when we took stuff out, it was like their heads were like touching the top. They grow like three times faster than a chicken grows. So if you're going to raise them at the same time, which is again what I would suggest, you need to take that into consideration, the size of your brooder, both the height and the actual like the depth of the dimensions of it, because they're going to outgrow it really, really fast. They're big animals. They again, like you need a place for them to sleep. So if you are going to keep them in a stationary coop, which is not something I would recommend, perfectly honest. You literally need a hole big enough for them to get through. They generally run about 3 feet and like they can duck down. I mean, obviously they have very big necks, but they need a proper place to one, be able to get in and out of the coop, but also like a proper place to nest within the coop. They're not going to fit into a standard nesting box. So again, more things you need to consider. They're big and they grow a lot faster. Okay, number three. Geese live for a really long time. I think you're gonna find pretty much this entire video is about how geese are just different than chickens. Oh, hi kitty. And they are. But this is a thing you need to consider. It's like a cat. It is a like almost lifelong commitment. I am part of a Facebook group for backyard ducks and geese, because again, they're very different and you need to know a different set of things when you're raising waterfowl as opposed to chickens. And there was a woman who posted a photo of her geese, her goose, who was 42. 42. She said the last time she had laid eggs was a couple years ago. She was, I think, 37 at the time. So just think about that. Like, how old are you now? How old are you going to be when that goose comes to full maturity? Like, you're gonna be with this goose for a long time. So just take that into consideration that they are gonna live for a really long time. Chickens, you know, their lifespan is usually much shorter. If you're keeping them for egg laying, you're gonna wanna get rid of them probably a little bit sooner because they're gonna stop laying eggs. But geese are gonna, they're gonna be around for a long time.
Come on, babies.
Number four. So geese have a very different social structure, social hierarchy than chickens do. And this is something that you're really gonna wanna consider when you're thinking about what kind of geese you want. And I'll get into that in a minute. We'll say I just mean male or female, and how many. So I do know people that have a goose and a gander. A gander is literally just a male goose. And they have them in with a flock of chickens and they are okay. I also know of a lot of people who run into more problems because of that. So because geese live for a really long time, they are more like people. They build strong family units. They will bond with each other over bonding with chickens if they are not raised together. Or if they have the ability to pair off, they will do that. And again, they're gonna put the safety of their family unit over the safety of the chickens. So, for example, we had, I chose to only get females. One, I wanted eggs, which is I highly recommend. And I wanted to make sure that they wouldn't pair off and stop taking care of the chickens. So, the interesting thing about that was when Greta's sister Gertrude was still alive, it was very sweet, they would still protect the flock, but they were able to take turns laying on the nest because they do protect their nest. I find with Greta and also with Gertrude, so Greta likes me, she's bonded with me, I am her mom, I am literally Mother Goose, so she's very snuggly with me, but particularly around nesting time, just before they start laying eggs, she gets especially snuggly. I don't know if it's because she's confused, there's no gander around, and she's like trying to look for a mate or what it is, but she just like, she's so snuggly. She just wants to be held and nuzzled, and then she'll start laying her eggs. And she'll go in and sit and lay on her eggs for a big part of the day. Now, when she's doing that, it means she's not protecting the flock. She laid eggs in the spring and in the fall, which was surprising. I thought they only laid eggs in the spring. Goose eggs are a huge, huge benefit as far as I'm concerned. Again, they'll lay eggs for a really long time because they live for a really long time. So they're not laying eggs on a consistent basis like chickens where they're laying them every day or every, you know, few days, but they do lay these amazing, beautiful eggs. They're about 3 times the size of a chicken egg and they have this beautiful yolk, super rich yolk.
Oh my God, it's huge!
Good
Lord.
Look at the size of this thing.
It's warm. Some people do have sensitivity to duck and goose eggs, though, like you could be allergic to them. And if you think that that may be an issue for you, I would avoid, you know, like just making a duck egg omelet or a goose egg omelet. But if you don't think that that's an issue for you, that's great. They are these super rich, rich, rich eggs. I make a lot of custards and pies, like I bake with them and stuff. So they're just a really great thing to have, and it's a big benefit. But because their nesting schedule is different, because they live longer, their social hierarchy, their social structure is just so different. So it was very key that we did not have a gander. We don't have a lot of geese. If I were going to have a lot of geese, and I may in the future, I would have them separate from the flock. And if I did have geese that I was raising with my chickens to protect them, I would keep them only with that flock always. Because again, they're not gonna see the chickens as their flock to protect if they weren't raised with them and they don't have another option, you know, as long as they don't have another option to sort of pair off. Again, coming back to having two females, I would like to get another female because they were able to take turns being sisters. They were able to take turns on laying on the nest so that one could stay with the flock and one can stay on the nest. Now it all falls to Greta, my poor baby. So I would like to get, you know, I think getting two females is a really good idea. If you're gonna get a gander, maybe only get that gander, just one, and make sure that you raise him with the flock so he does not tear your chickens apart. Number five, this is kind of, it's kind of all the same stuff that I keep coming back around to. Geese are different than chickens. That also means that they have different body parts. So if you are going to get a gander, you need to be very careful about that. I don't hear this happening as much with geese as I do hear it happening a lot with ducks, male ducks. So a rooster's sex organs are inside his body. A waterfowl's are not. They, if you really want to give yourself nightmares, look up like duck or goose penis online. It's a really freaky looking thing. They are outside of their body, and if a male goose or duck tries to mate with a hen, they can actually pull the insides out of their body. It's not a good scene. So again, I would always say get a female because then you don't have to worry about it. But you do need to be aware of it. It all comes down to the fact that geese are just different animals than chickens. They have different needs. Their social structures are different. Their bodies are different. But I still say, hands down, getting a guard goose was the best thing we ever did. We did it right though. We raised them with the baby chicks in the same brooder. The way we did it was to, we had one big brooder that we were able to divide into three sections because we got three sections because we got three different rounds of birds. We got one from one place, one from another, and then we had our geese. So we kept the geese in one side so they could hear each other, they could smell each other, they were near each other. It gave them a little separation. And then after about 2 weeks, we were able to pull the partitions up and let them commingle. So those geese were used to those chickens and those chickens were used to those geese. We made sure we had water that the geese could get their, you know, get their beaks into, blow their snot out. We made sure they had the proper food with the proper protein. And because of that, they have rewarded us multiple times that I have literally watched I have watched them protect the flock from aerial predators. Again, I still say two females is the best possible scenario. And I will put a link in the notes down below of where we got our geese. I don't know what was up with the genetics. I actually mean to, I meant to send them an email, but one of them did end up with cancerous growths on her face. But Myers was super great from the beginning. They answered so many of my questions. They refunded me for the third goose we had that didn't make it. So they're very, very helpful. A great company to work with. I can't say enough about them. But having those two female geese, we got eggs. They have a chance to take turns on the nest. And what they would do is if a hawk swoops down and tries to get into the chicken tractor area, we run our chickens on pasture with a Premier One solar netting around the outside. Protects them from predators from the side, but that means aerial predators can still get down. Our chicken tractor is pretty small, so they have a lot of space they can walk around. When a hawk comes down, the geese are always scanning the sky. Usually what they would do is one goose would round up all the chickens, get them into the safety of the structure, and the other goose would just stick her wings up, get as big as she possibly could, make as much noise as she could, and she would scare the geese off. And I mean, I've literally watched them do it so many times. It is the most amazing thing. I mean, I've had hawks come down and try to get my chickens when I'm, you know, 3 yards away. I'm not that far away. They don't care about me, but they won't mess with the geese. So they're funny. I love watching them take baths in their water bucket. They splash it all over themselves. They're very bonded with me, my husband. They're not great with children, so I wish I had done a little bit more work from the beginning, getting them used to the kids. But they're just doing their job. They're just protecting their flock, and they're really good at it. So I absolutely recommend it, but you do need to do your research. You do need to know what you need to have on hand, and you just need to be aware of some things before you go getting this goose. Again, I can't speak to getting a fully grown goose and trying to integrate them into the flock. That's a whole nother story. So hopefully this helped. Okay guys, that's it. I'm sorry, I know this was super lengthy, but I hope that gave you the information you need before you go and order your guard geese. I wish you the best of luck. I just want you to know what you're getting into ahead of time, but I will leave you with a video of my sweet baby Gigi's taking a tubby. Bye. Time for morning bath. Oh, girls. Oh, Gertrude, you're getting nice and clean this morning.